So in the previous class, we had already discussed about the covalent bonding and how bonding formation takes place. So now we will discuss about the versatile nature of the carbon. So already we had seen the formation of covalent bonds by the sharing of electrons in various elements and compounds, and we also had seen the structure of simple carbon compound, that is methane. So now so many things are there we use that contain carbon. In fact, we ourselves are made up of carbon compounds, and the property of carbon to form large bond or long chain, that is seen only in the carbon and no other elements. So the nature of the covalent bond enables the carbon to form a large number of compounds. So based on that, some factors are noticed in case of carbon. This is that first one is that carbon has the unique ability to form bonds with other carbon, giving rise to large molecule, and that property is called catenation. That means carbon has the ability to form bonds with other atoms, giving rise to large molecules. So these compounds may have long chains of carbon, branched chains of carbon, even carbon atoms are arranged in rings. So in addition to carbon atoms may be linked as single bond or double bond or triple bond. So we had already discussed how they are forming the single bond and the double bond or the triple bond. So compounds of carbon which are linked by only one bond or the single bond between two carbon atoms, these are called saturated compounds. And compounds of carbon having double or triple bonds between the two carbon atoms, they are called unsaturated compounds. So here carbon atoms are also two types, carbon compounds are also two types, like saturated carbon compounds and unsaturated carbon compounds. So the bonds, when they are having two carbon atoms, when they are linked by single bond, that is known as saturated carbon compounds. Two carbon atoms, when they are linked by either double or triple bond, they are known as unsaturated compounds. No other elements exhibit the property of catenation to the extent seen in the carbon compounds. Silicon forms compounds with hydrogen which have chain of up to 7 or 8 atoms, but the compounds are very reactive. Carbon-carbon bond is very strong and hence stable. So carbon-carbon bond, when these are formed, these are very stable bond. This give us the large number of compounds with many carbon atoms linked with each other. So another factor that is noticed in carbon is that since carbon has a valency of 4, it is capable of bonding with the 4 atoms of carbon or atoms of some other monovalent elements. So compounds of carbon are formed with oxygen, hydrogen, nitrogen, sulfur, chlorine, many other elements, giving rise to compounds with specific properties which depends on the elements other than the carbon present in the molecules. So again, the bonds that carbon forms with most other elements are very strong, making these compounds exceptionally stable. So for this reason, for the formation of strong bonds by carbon is its small size. Because of the small size, this enables the nucleus to hold onto shared pairs of electrons strongly. The bonds formed by elements having bigger atoms are much weaker. So if we will consider the saturated and unsaturated compounds, then we can see how the carbon is forming the single bond or the double and triple bond, and since it is having a valency of 4, it is capable of bonding with the 4 other atoms of carbon or atoms of some other monovalent element. So normally compounds of carbon are formed with oxygen, hydrogen, methane, like with hydrogen, then carbon dioxide, carbon and oxygen, with nitrogen also it can form sulfur, chlorine, so many other elements. They form compound with specific properties which depend on the elements other than the carbon present in the molecules. So now we will see saturated and unsaturated carbon compounds. So saturated carbon compound means when two carbon atoms are linked by a single bond, that is called saturated carbon compounds. And the structure of methane we had seen the structure of methane. So another compound formed between the carbon and hydrogen is ethane. After methane, it is ethane, and ethane formula is C2 H6. So here two carbon atoms are linked by single bond. So to arrive at the structure of simple carbon compounds, first of all we have to link the carbon atoms together with a single bond, and then we will use hydrogen. So to get the structure of this, so first of all we will link the two carbon atoms with a single, since it is a saturated carbon compounds, first of all we will link the carbon two carbon atoms with a single bond, then we will use the hydrogen to satisfy the remaining valencies of the carbon. For example, now we will do carbon atomic number is 6, so it is 2, 4. We will take the outermost orbit, and here hydrogen is 1. So first of all we will make the single bond between the two carbon atoms. So now here both the carbon atoms are having 4 electrons, like 1, 2, 3, 4 for this carbon, another one is 1, 2, 3, 4 for this carbon. So I had arranged it so that it will be easy to make the bond formation. So this carbon is having 1, 2, 3, 4 electrons, this carbon is having 1, 2, 3, 4 electrons. So now we will arrange the oxygen. So now you can see here one electron is required, so here we will arrange the oxygen. Here also we will arrange, and here similarly here. So now we can see the bond formation. Hydrogen is arranged with the help of dot and carbon is arranged with the cross. So now we will form the bond formation. So hydrogen is satisfied with 2 electrons. Here also hydrogen is satisfied with 2 electrons, and here also hydrogen is satisfied with 2 electrons. Similarly here also hydrogen is satisfied with 2, here also hydrogen with 2, and here also hydrogen is with 2. So now carbon we will satisfy. So carbon will be here after sharing. This carbon is now satisfied with the octet rule or 8 electrons. So here also again in the same way, if we will do, you can see this carbon is also now having 8 electrons, and one pair of electron is shared between the two carbons. So here this single bond formation takes place because one pair of electron is shared between the two carbons, and here is with hydrogen, here also with hydrogen, and here also with hydrogen. Similarly here, here, and here also with hydrogen. So along with the electron dot structure, you can write the structure of the ethane as two carbon atoms are linked by a single bond, and then with the hydrogen, one carbon atom is with 3 hydrogen, this carbon atom is also with 3 hydrogen. So this is the structure of ethane. Similarly you can draw the structure of propane or butane. So you can do it, you do it in your home. In the next class we will discuss about the unsaturated carbon compounds.